Let's build a dashboard. Here we will look at how we can add the KPIs, how we can add different types of charts that makes up a good dashboard than simple and pivot table, as well as other objects like text and images and maps. Adding KPIs. KPIs are the key performance indicators, which helps evaluating the key performance indicators, as the name suggests, the critical sales metrics, or any other metrics as per your domain, maybe financial metric or a stock market metric if you are analyzing stock market data, and it is something that you want to keep on your radar, then you create the KPIs. So let's go and see how we can create a KPI within Qlik Sales. Here we are in our sheet, and right now the sheet is empty, so let's go ahead and go into edit mode. If you have been using the previously created sheet and want to create a new one, you can even come over here and create a new sheet. If you have saved the work that we have shown previously into the new sheet. All right, so how we can add the KPI is very simple. We need to go into master charts over here, the chart section, and over here we have the KPI, so we can pick this and drag it here, and as you can see, it is expecting a measure. So let's go ahead and give it a measure. So maybe what we can give is sales. So over here, sales, and we want sum of sales, right? 14.92 million. So by default, it is taking the formatting and everything. And over here, it is giving you the title sum of sales. So let's change it to the sales. So over here, when I clicked over there, here is an expression and here is a label. And let's change it to sales. All right, let me change my caps lock. Sales, and click outside, and it will be changed to sales. Then you can go ahead and drag it as per your needs, right? And as you can see that as I'm dragging, the value inside is taking the shape accordingly that text box is. Similarly, let's create another KPI. And as I am creating another one, you can see it is taking the shape or dimension as per the previous KPI. So let's add the measure, and here let's add the profit, and let's take the sum of profit, which is 1.52 million. So it is clearly indicating that when we made a sale of 14.92 million across different products, across different regions, we are getting the profit of the 1.52 million. Now, if I need to change the title, I can come over here and change it to profit. Right? Over here, we have a couple of other options like number formatting. By default, it is auto. So I suggest that we should keep it auto because that looks much more nicer as compared to the one which we can choose it from the options. For example, if I choose money, see how it looks like. As well as if I choose number or maybe something else. So auto, I believe, is gives us the good indication, but you have the flexibility where you can go and change it. Apart from that, you can delete the KPI, the profit KPI, if you don't need it further. Also, if you see, you have another option where you can add another KPI. So for example, if I click add, it will ask me, let's say I want to add discount. So discount, and I will take average discount. And as you can see, my profit is coming here, 1.52 million, and the average discount is 5%. And let me change the label to discount. All right, when I change it to discount, I am now clearly seeing that my profit is 1.52 million with 0.05 discount, which I have given across different categories. Now, what I can do is, over here in the filter pane, I can get the dimension. Let's say, for example, I want to take order priority, and over here, let me drag it. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 priority. So let's say if I click on done and click on order priority 3 and confirm the selection, the sale it is making 3.27 million, the profit and 0.05 discount. So all of these are very flexible based on what we are choosing, and based on whatever selection we make, we can see how our KPIs are changing. So as you can see, KPI making within the Qlik sense is very simple, and we have other options like even appearance, where we can give some properties like we want to show the title, we want to show the details, as well as some sort of a sorting about how we want to sort it. But here it's not really matter because it's just one value. And in data, simple it is to create a KPI and the first and the second KPI based on the second KPI that we are specifying. Apart from that, it has some features like the data handling, if you want to have any calculation condition, as well as appearance related to general, whether you want to show the title, show the details, presentation about how we want to present, center, font size is medium, link to sheet is interesting one where you can link another sheet. Let's say I am over here sales and I want to link to a different sheet. I can enable this and I can select the sheet if I have created any, so that whenever anybody is clicking here, it will take to the sales sheet for more granular information. Like this, you have the option of colors over here, and you can specify conditional coloring based on how the value is. So for example, up to 1 million is red, 2 million is yellow, and anything above 2 million is basically green. You can specify the conditional coloring by enabling this. You can keep on adding the limit and keep giving the colors, so that will keep changing the values based on what you have specified. So as you can see, we can do a lot of stuff with the KPIs and make it actionable for our user.